Why am I yellow? Male, look, can't look at himself in the mirror. Differential diagnosis.
Maybe it's a neurological problem?
Oh, and he's yellow.
So you mean he's jaundiced?
Well, if you want to get technical, I mean, we all went to medical school.
Are there any other symptoms?
Anorexia, slight weight loss, no ascites, no fever.
What about his lab results?
Hey, who's asking the questions? Okay, well, amylase 124, total bilirubin 278.3, direct bilirubin 237.1 and ALP 236.
Maybe the accumulation of bilirubin is a result of an obstruction of the liver.
Well, there's a buildup of direct bilirubin, so it'd have to be extrahepatic. If we had a full liver function test, we'd know for sure.
Excellent. 10 points. AST and ALT are normal. Therefore, there's no intrahepatic obstruction.
Well, then it's obvious, it's a gallstone, especially with his age.
Yeah, but is there any pain?
Nope.
Well then, a gallstone is highly unlikely. Maybe it's viral. How about hepatitis?
Nope. HIV and HBV are negative. But I think you guys are forgetting something.
Yeah, but an increased amylase could be caused by pretty much anything. I mean, renal problems, but there's an issue with glomerular filtration.
Nope. Urea and creatinine are both normal.
Well, I still think my theory is most likely. A gallstone could be blocking the common bile duct, and that would lead to an increased amylase and jaundice.
Okay, well, go get me a picture of the gallstone. I'll go talk to the patient. Let's go. Whoa! Is it yellow in here or is it just you?
Who are you?
I'm your doctor.
It's nice to finally meet you.
Let's just cut to the chase. Do you drink or do you take any drugs?
No.
Do you smoke?
Yeah. Could that be making me yellow?
Well, depends. How much?
Half a pack? 20 years?
Well, let's just say, if you live through this, you might want to consider cutting that habit.
Did you find out anything?
No drugs, no alcohol.
Well, that's a good thing then.
Well, he did smoke half a pack a day for 20 years. I think we have a new clue.
I found a mass. It's on the head of the pancreas. I think it's adenoma.
Well, that was easy. Who's going to tell the patient?
No, it can't. I mean, we can't just hand him a death sentence without being sure. At least let me run an endoscopic ultrasound.
Why? Because it messes with your perfect world?
I just think we should be sure.
Fine, we'll get an aspiration while you're at it and go with her.
I don't know why we're doing this. The EES already shows that it's cancer.
But the aspiration will just make sure.
I think you're in denial. These cells are definitely abnormal. This is definitely a pancreatic adenoma. I'm gonna go tell us.
Adenoma at the head of the pancreas. The EUS and the cytological analysis confirmed it.
Finally convinced? So, who's gonna tell the patient?
House.
Okay, we'll all go tell the patient. Let's go. Well, we have good news and bad news. Which do you want first?
The good news.
Good news is we found out what you have. Bad news is it's cancer.
The head of the pancreas, to be exact.
Is that what's making me yellow?
Well, we do commonly see jaundice when with cancer associated with the head of the pancreas, usually due to an obstruction of the common bile duct.
That could also explain why you're not eating well and why you're losing weight.
Can you guys fix me?
Well, most patients with pancreatic cancer die of their disease.
So that means...
Let's just say you have less than 1% chance of surviving the next 5 years.
But there is always the chance that we'll be able to surgically remove the tumor. And if it's successful, then we'll have you go through rounds of chemotherapy and radiation.
But if the surgeons can't remove the tumor, all we can do is really alleviate your symptoms. This would help remove your jaundice, as well as get you eating normally.
Yeah, basically, it doesn't look good.
But we'll refer you to our best surgeons, and they'll do everything they can to help you out.
It coming now, you can't stop yourself. Now you're your pride and you climb the hill.